ィリピンの首都マニラから北西およそ120キロに位置するオロンガポ市。かつてスービック海軍基地のあったこの場所は、現在経済特区として様々な国の企業が集まっています。レストランやバー、レジャー施設も立ち並び、観光地としても人々に親しまれています。
Just to give you an idea to compare it, during the time of the U.S. Navy, there were 17,000 Filipinos employed and another 20,000, indirectly employed, with contractors and service providers to the U.S. Navy. So, when the U.S. Navy was here, the base itself was responsible for almost 37,000 jobs. There are now almost 1,300 companies operational and, in terms of workers, there are about 90,000 workers already in the zone.
And I had to find out how best I can utilize Subic in case the Americans suddenly leave or we ask them to leave. So I thought the best one was a transshipment point, a free port where business can be done very fast. Well, we're more secure with our development, unlike before. When there was no ships, the economy will go down.
現在、経済特区として栄える工業団地であり、リゾート地帯に姿を変えているこの場所。1991年に返還されるまで、アジア最大規模のアメリカ海軍基地がありました。米軍基地はなぜ撤去されたのか、また基地はこの町に何を残したのか、取材しました。アメリカによる植民地支配が始まった20世紀初頭。その後、100年以上にわたり、アメリカは重要な軍事拠点としてフィリピンの基地機能を拡大していきました。中でもスービック海軍基地は、訓練、補給、通信施設を備えるアジア太平洋のアメリカ海軍基地として主要な役割を担っていました。基地面積は2万ヘクタール以上。現在、沖縄に駐在する米軍施設の総面積に匹敵します。
They bought supplies from the city, no, or surrounding the bases. They also recruited base workers among Filipinos in the surrounding areas. SoThey made the local communities very, very dependent. We were made to become dependent on them, a foreign power, for our external defense. You see, that's why if you, at that time, the fear of many Filipinos that if you remove the bases, you remove our ability to defend ourselves against enemies.
基地拡大の根拠となったのがフィリピン独立の翌年、1947年に締結された米非軍事基地協定です。アメリカはスービック基地を含む16カ所の基地を維持するだけでなく、さらに拡張することも可能となりました。これらの基地が朝鮮戦争やベトナム戦争では重要な出撃拠点となりました。しかし、この協定が執行を迎える1991年を前に、各地で米軍基地撤廃の声が上がり始めたのです。
For us, especially my generation, we've considered the U.S. military facilities in the Philippines as a symbol of U.S. domination. The military base agreement is going to expire in 1991. And we felt that the best time to prepare for it
Treaty that was submitted to us for concurrence was violative of the constitution. It has come out that it has served as an obstacle. No? The U.S. bases have been here for such a long time. It was really time for them to go.
People power と呼ばれる民衆の革命によってマルコス独裁政権を倒したフィリピン。基地はマルコス時代の象徴でもありました。 しかし当選した秋の大統領は基地撤廃を公約に掲げていたものの、就任後に基地存続を表明。基地撤廃派と基地存続派は激しく対立しました。
We did get a lot of pressure, no, from many sectors. From the U.S. Government itself, there was pressure, no. They were telling us, if you reject this treaty, we will no longer be your allies.
Yes, I was against it, because we don't have a military that is credible. And we have to build up our military, because I think America treated the Philippines better with bases.
We developed these radio spots, 30-seconder, 50-seconder radio spots that dramatizes the issue, no? How an ordinary person would look at, you know, the presence of military facilities, dealing with different aspects of it, the political, social, as well as environmental aspect of the issue.
Many of those who were in favor of the U.S. bases remaining changed their minds.
We were in front of the Philippine Senate. It was a big demonstration because we were waiting for the final voting of the senator. 200,000, I remember, coming from different places, even outside Metro Manila. When the Senate President, Jovito Salonga, declared the final decision, we were, of course, all of us were very happy, and we all marched towards the cultural center.
この日、フィリピン上院議会が新基地協定の批准を否決。アメリカ政府は基地存続を模索し、フィリピン政府との交渉を試みましたが、交渉は決裂。そして翌年11月、1世紀以上続いた米軍基地はフィリピン全土から完全に撤退しました。一方で基地は人々に大きな爪痕を残しました。基地撤退後問題となったアメリカ兵とフィリピン人女性との間に生まれたアメラジアンと呼ばれる子どもたち。彼らの多くは父親が帰国しており、経済的援助も受けられず、差別や貧困に苦しみました。1996年の調査によると、フィリピン全土に3万人はいたと言われています。
We asked to the government of United States to support the 8,000 American kid in the Enolonga po. That is 1993 when we go to United States to file a class suit. But what's the reason is when we file, they dismiss the case. Because it's, you know, it's not the obligation of United States. It is the obligation of American guy.
そしてもう一つ、有毒物質による汚染です。基地周辺では、米軍の残した廃棄物によって、多くの人がさまざまな被害を受けていました。
ako ay nagtrabaho dati sa dumping. Tapos, pero ano na ako, nag-walk up na ako kasi nakaramdam na nga ako ng ano, ng yung anemic na ako. Naa-anemic ako dahil minsan nakakalimutan na rin mag-vitamin. Dapat po ano yung naaamoy ko sa basura. Kaya ganun ang ano ko sa dumping. Sa mga parents ko naman, nagkaroon din sila ng yun sa ganyan sa toxic. Dahil nakuha nila yung cancer nila sa breast nila. Tapos yung kapatid ko, kung nakuha din sa pamumutla din yung te. Pamumutla. Tapos yung isa naman talagang inborn na na hindi siya lumalaki talaga. Pareha sila. Ganun lang ang ano ko.
米軍の残した弾薬庫や基地周辺の廃棄物処理場は有害な化学物質で汚染されていました。後の調査でその中にはアスベストや発がん性のあるカドミウムなども含まれると発表されています。土壌に広がった汚染は河川にまで及んでいました。これらの事実は基地が返還され初めて明らかになったのです。かつて基地周辺に住んでいたフェルナンデスさん、母親の体内に蓄積した汚染物質が娘のキャサリンさんに影響を及ぼしたのではないかと疑われています。周辺地域には同じような障害の子どもが次々に生まれています。
Catherine is cerebral palsy. Then, ano siya, bedridden. Tapos, tungkol naman sa ano niya, sa katawan niya, mas madalas siyang magka-sipon, sa plema, saka, hindi na siya, hindi, ganito na siya, hindi na siya lumalaki. Yung ano mo, parang awang-awa ka sa kanya pag may masakit sa kanya, hindi mo malaman kung ano yung masakit sa kanya. Minsan umiyak siya, yung parang umiingit siya, hindi mo alam kung ano yung makatit sa kanya, baka may kumakagat sa kanya. Kaya kung ano nararamdaman niya, hindi mo malaman. Tapos hindi mo siya mapakain ng kagaya sa ibang bata ng pagkain. Hindi na ako makapunta sa mga gusto kong puntahan. Kailangan ko pang may maiwan sa kanya kung pupunta ako sa kung saan, bawa sa Longapo o kung saan ako pupunta. Kailangan, ano, limitado ang oras ko, hindi ako pwede magtagal.
の実態は米国会計検査院の報告書でも明らかになっていますが、協定によってアメリカは原状回復の一切の義務を負わないとされています。19年前、米軍基地に脳を突きつけたフィリピンの人々。普天間移設問題に揺れる日本は彼らの目にどう映っているのでしょうか。
The Japanese people are the ones funding the operations of the bases. You are in a better position to, you know, you are not dependent on them economically. I think that this is an opportunity, especially with your new government, no?
The option of closing the base does not seem to be an option for the government. And that's sad, you know, because for many years, and I would say decades, the Okinawan people have been relentlessly saying, we want the base out of Okinawa. And the new government, the new regime in Japan should listen to that, that there's no other alternative.
Presence of U.S. military bases, not only in the Philippines but in other countries, may no longer really be that vital. Issues like poverty, like landlessness, like inequality, like injustice, no? Which breed social conflict, no? and wars, no? If there could just be this sustained efforts to address these basic problems of the people all over the world, there would be no need to continue to have the presence of these U.S. military bases in the other countries.